Yeah, hey, welcome back to Power Wash Simulator. That whole thing looks nice. Oh, shit. Oh, no. My tab key ain't working. Oh, no, the tab key is working. That's misleading. So, this has happened to me a couple times when I was playing. The highlight function just quits. It just stops working. And that, I'm so glad this is the last episode. Because that shit sucks. It pisses me off so much. Because I basically have to quit the whole game and come back in. And I don't really feel like doing that right now. That statue is of you, right? What? What statue? Is there a statue here? Hadn't seen one. How does it feel to be worshipped as a god by ancient underwater civilization destroyed thousands of years before your birth? A little odd. I mean, hadn't seen the statue, but I can be pretty damn sure it ain't me. Bunch of underwater people would probably not want to worship this guy. Well, that actually has a double meaning. They would not want to worship Red, me. They definitely wouldn't want to worship the guy who's constantly wasting water. The planet is running out of clean water. All the damn time. We have found some ways to fix our clean water issue, but we're still running out of it. It's part of our climate change problem. So the guy who is using what is definitely clear water, clean water, to spray off mud when civilizations didn't used to, like, fastidiously clean as much as we do, I don't think anybody would have worshipped this dude. Not if they were far back enough, yet far forward enough looking that they could worship somebody, they probably would not worship the guy who does this as a job. Especially when there's so many people who do this as a job. Oh, thank goodness the tab key's working. It was something that I was not looking forward to having to deal with. I'm just glad it actually fucking did what I needed it to. When I needed it to. Sort of out of left field here, but I don't know if this confuses you as much as it confuses me. Basically everybody's boat showed up. Like, see, look at that. They got the shrimper out there and the helicopter here. Oh. I could swear there were more of them. I guess I just full on fucking imagined every damn vehicle. You know, I could swear that all of the boats. Wait, why would all of the boats? I mean, it's just like the one boat. Because actually, yeah, this is basically all of the vehicles. And you know what? My point still stands. I'm confused as to why there are two vehicles out here and people are texting me as though they are here. Like, if you're here, don't text me. That's fucking rude. Like, how the hell would you not realize that that's, like, incredibly rude? It's like saying, you don't want to talk to me, but you have to talk to me, so you're going to send me a message so you don't have to actually see me or verbally speak to me. Fuck you, you're an asshole. But aside from that, nobody's here. I can look out at the shrimper and nobody's there. I can look at that helicopter and nobody's there. Nobody's actually with me. They all just, like, claim that they are. I don't know. And who the fuck's paying me for this shit? Like, I get the ancient monument thing, the archaeologists, they're probably giving me some of their grant money from a university, like, hey, this thing needed to be cleaned off, otherwise we wouldn't have been able to fucking read the writings on it or any of that stuff, so we hired a power washer to come and do it. But this is just an ancient temple. Like, I shouldn't, I'm not even sure of the legality of me power washing this thing. Like, am I allowed to do this? Who owns this? If it's far out enough into the water that it's in international waters, nobody's got jurisdiction. But then you'd have people all over the planet fucking fighting for it. Based on how far out it looks like we are, yeah, it looks like we're in international waters. Also, how the hell has this thing not been noticed? This is an island with a temple on it, like in the Pacific or in the Atlantic Ocean. Based on the fact that they're talking about volcanic rings in the Pacific Rim, I'd say it's in the Pacific Ocean. But it's like not possible at this point for us to have missed an island with a fucking temple on it. And I just thought about something too. There's a big change from the way I used to play the game that since I started using this triple sprayer has changed pretty drastically. I just don't stop spraying anymore. I used to stop spraying with the yellow or the green and like run around and plan things out because I was going to plan everything out exactly how I was going to clean it, get it to like fit into an exact design of how I was going to clean it. You know that the Red Dragon from Red Dragon, Ralph Fiennes, where he was like, this is my design kind of thing. This is the way that I designed everything out. I'm going to clean stuff in this precise pattern. And now I hit right click and I'm holding the mouse and my fingers are off the buttons. Just trying as best as I can to not push those buttons because then I would stop spraying. And I'm just trying to hit everything. If I look up or if I look down, I want it to hit random spots. And with Tab actually giving me my fucking dirt indicator again, I'm perfectly fine with how much of this is going to get left dirty. And I'm going to have to go back and clean it later because I'll be able to actually fucking find it. Pal here, there's no chance of getting near the volcano's rim, but I've spotted something weird. Getting closer to look. Okay, volcano seems like it's angry still. So why are you trying to get closer to the rim of the volcano? It's an abandoned mobile mining drill. It's broken into the magma chamber itself. I mean, that wouldn't set off a volcano. The operation likely destabilized the whole place. What has the mayor done? You're saying the mayor set up a mining operation into the volcano, and because of the mining drill, it destabilized the volcano, causing it to erupt. I don't think you're a geologist. Real quick, for anybody who cares, and I guess for anybody who doesn't, if you're still watching anyway, there's something in... I've been an English teacher for years, and there's something in narration called an unreliable narrator. It's a very common thing nowadays. Most people know what it is, but just in case you don't know what the hell that is, it means that whoever is telling the story isn't somebody whom you can necessarily trust to tell that story truthfully. Now, that might be because they don't know the truth. That might be because they're lying to you. That might be because they have a completely different sense of what everything is. It's like asking about the 2016 or the 2020 presidential election here in the United States. You're going to get a lot of unreliable narrators who have either no idea what the hell went on, or people who ignore a large portion of evidence just so that they can claim one specific event happened in a particular way. That's an unreliable narrator. Now, that is not a completely pointless thing for me to go over here. I just said that guy is not a geologist. I don't think he is one. I'm starting to think he's an unreliable narrator of events. I met him... Well, the character seems to have met him before, based on their communications with each other early on in the game. But, he said he was a geologist. That may or may not be true. It's possible that he's like an undercover reporter. He could be somebody who's trying to get dirt on the mayor, and he's trying to blame the mayor for everything because the mayor's gone and can't defend himself anymore. Could be a political rival of the mayor. Now, I don't like the mayor. The mayor's a piece of shit. He's a corrupt politician. Most politicians are corrupt in some way, blah, blah, blah. But I think that it's very possible that this geologist fella is not actually a geologist and is simply unreliable for telling the story of what's going on here. I'm talking to archaeologists who are scientists. They are, by the basic definition, they are scientists. And I'm talking to a geologist who, by the basic definition, is a scientist. But I don't entirely trust any of them. I'm starting to think, like, maybe none of these people are reliable narrators at all. But you know what? Actually, that would be a double layer. Because technically, it's not about who is giving the information in the story. The narrator is usually in a reliable or unreliable narrator sort of situation. The narrator is actually the POV character, which in this case would be the power wash guy. So maybe the power wash guy is an unreliable narrator. Finally get to take a look at this fucking statue. This statue is not me. Why would you think that it is? Like, I understand all the murals everywhere, but not the statue. The murals flat out show all of the things that I've cleaned with this power washer, but that statue is a thing with a backpack. And maybe I could see the hands being like water, kind of like spraying up. But water spraying up out of the hand doesn't really fit with what a power washer is or looks like. Cleaning this fucking floor up here, kind of annoying because of all the damn bumps in it. I got the raised up thing. Now, I gotta go and find all these little specks that I missed throughout the rest of the cleaning process, because I was ignoring the floor as best as possible, just like I had been downstairs. I was looking up the whole time, just so that I wouldn't have to look down at the floor. It was like, if I take a turn and hit tab, you can fucking see it. I don't like the floor down there, and I am not looking forward to going back down there. Procrastination by doing one thing that I'm supposed to get done because I don't want to do a different thing that I'm also supposed to get done. In my further efforts to avoid the floor, or at least avoid cleaning it, because I'm definitely standing on it, I'm go ahead and try to clean off this statue, which is broken into parts. And this is another one of those cases where I really appreciate it being broken into parts. It's all like individual things that make sense to be broken up. Clean the symbol, clean the backpack, clean the other thing. Like, that makes this a lot easier than simply clean the fucking statue. You know what a statue is. I tell you what, based on how long I've been going, this might end up being just as long as the last episode. Or, you know what? I keep saying, like, length of an episode. I don't know what the length of the episode is. I just know how long the fucking recording is. And even then, I'm not 100% sure. A lot of the time, I just hit record, hit stop recording, and then the time goes away, and then I don't know how long I've been recording either. I don't look at my watch as often as I should. There are traces of old luminous ore everywhere. I've never seen anything like it. There's a lot of shit like that all over the damn place. See, again, I'm really starting to think you're not a geologist. There's something else up here. A volcano? A magma flow. It's gonna run your ass over if you don't get the fuck out of there. Seemed like an idiot to me. An aircraft just shot straight out of the volcano and it's heading your way. An aircraft? Is it the aliens? Or they're not aliens, they're future scientists flying around in a flying saucer. I don't see anything. Oh well, there's actually more stuff up here in the gallery that I missed anyway. But I don't see any flying things coming over this way. You'd think I'd see it, considering there's nothing but clear airspace all the way boat to get over here. Still hadn't gotten the fucking floor, the rest of the floor in here. I'm gonna just fuck it. I'm cleaning the floor in here. It's gonna take so goddamn long. And you know what? This is the final episode. I don't care. This video file is going to be fucking massive. It's going to take forever to edit. It's going to be a long damn episode. I'm getting it done today because I don't want to play this game after today. You know, I get all excited that a bunch of the floor is cut up into sections and for the most part already clean, and forget about the fact that when it is done that way, it's mostly in speckles once I've finished everything else. Can barely fucking find anything to clean. It's on its last little fucking tiny little bar of health. I can't find all of the specks. Keep finding little bitty ones and cleaning them up. And they're just never enough. Fucking finally. I was about to say one day I would accept that it would never be clean, but oh, thank goodness it was not. It was not going to come down to that. I like the exterior of this pyramid. The outside of this temple looks really nice when it's cleaned. And the inside really doesn't. I like the murals. I appreciate the work that went into those. But the colors in here are so dull. It just doesn't look as good as I feel like it ought to. I get like there's certain materials that they use to build the outside. There's going to be certain materials that they use to build the whole thing, so the outside and the inside. And without all the shininess on the outside, which I don't like, but it sort of helps the appearance. I don't like it for cleaning purposes, but it does make the appearance look nice. I kind of dislike those materials in here because there's no shininess. I like them for cleaning, but I don't like them too much for appearance. Hey, there we go. I got a fucking list. And the wall. Okay, so it's just a wall and the ceiling. It's a ceiling wall. All right, well, it does make this pretty easy. I can see all of the dirt. This is the Pyramidian gem as well. That is not something. It's not something I've seen. I'm gonna have to go look for that. I bet it's like that fucking Martian hatch door where it's like off in one of the corners of the island and I'm supposed to go find it and clean it off. I'll go and do that in a minute. I'm going to finish cleaning up this stuff because I can see it. That'll just be the last thing on my list. There is the ceiling wall. Ceiling inner? I'm missing that. Where? What is it? It is just this? I was hitting it. Just wasn't hitting all the worst spots, I guess. Or maybe I was hitting all the worst spots and there's still a percentage left. No, don't fall down the fucking hole. Got it. All right. I need to go and look for this gym. Where? There's not just some far off corner of the island, though. Holy shit! Well, I guess it was supposed to be my final fucking thing. Didn't show up until the very end. Am I on a timer for this damn thing? It's being pretty fucking loud. There. Done. There's the future scientists. And, whoa. Okay. That was the asshole with his anti-grav thing that I cleaned off. All right. Interesting. I'm okay with this angle. There was really no better way to do this. Most of the cleaning was interior, so there was no good way to do it. Power wash services, you did it. After you cleaned our ship, we went further back in time, methodically tracing your steps one job at a time, right back to the backyard cleaning days. While doing so, we pieced together Blake Thrust's ambitions. He was obsessed with the Lost City, and after discovering that their tech was powered by a rare ore, set up illegal mines there and here and everywhere. He struck a rich seam inside Rushless and used it to develop his own tech, while also hoping to create enough tectonic movement to push the Lost City up to the surface. All right, that's why this was not known to anybody. Please feel free to use this message as a customer review if you think it would help your business. Cool. That is it. There are no more missions. So, I get a nice little credits sequence. James Marsden? That's an interesting one. I'd be too concerned with the idea of having music on the channel that ain't mine because I don't know if it's like copyright or not. So, I hope you enjoyed this series. This is the third finale of Power Wash Simulator. And I hope you come back for what is next on the channel. I'll see y'all later. Bye.